on, her swagger sick. Plus her head dumb, back it up in the club truck. She colder than December. Fuck never befriend her, nothing on my agenda. I said I stay smoking. She said please let me roll it. That good weed got is floating. I got purple mixed with soda. I'm like wait, why you worry about how many hits I'm gon' take? What you should worry about, your bitch where she gon' be. I said I stay smoking. She said please let me roll it. That good weed got is floating. I got purple mixed with soda. I'm like wait, why you worry about how many hits I'm gon' take? What you should worry about, your bitch where she gon' be.
Yo, swag. I keep hearing these niggas saying they the wave of the future. Shit, you can call me Mr. Right Now. No games, EMT.
You already?
Yeah. It's not a fucking game, alright?
Team full of hell niggas. Natural born killers. Dollar with the swishers. Yeah, your bitch, you feel it. Talking money? Y'all fucking kill her. Text flip, caught y'all niggas slipping. Candy color cream, yeah, I'm fucking getting it. Dream team, how many times I gotta tell him?
Too many.
Ace and swag, you already. No games, you ain't too. Let's fucking do it. I said I stay smoking. She said please let me roll it. That good weed got is floating. I got purple mixed with soda. I'm like wait, why you worry about how many hits I'm gon' take? What you should worry about, your bitch wish gon' be. I said I stay smoking. She said please let me roll it. That good weed got is floating.
There comes a point,
swag,
and a relationship when it's time to dip.
No mercy, squad.
Bye, Felicia.
Shout out to Mister. Already. Don't get it twisted, not caught up in my feelings, dude. Let's get it, huh?
Been over.
Wave game.
Stack.
What's up? You hear what she's saying?
These niggas don't know you like I know you, girl.
No
questions asked. You were my work.
Yes.
I don't need you though. That's plain to see. I'm getting money, so these hoes wanna fuck with me.
Already.
I'm in a 13 Honda with some Tatianas. Had to cut that bitch off, cause I ain't with the drama.
Facts.
Breaking out, you fucking with a lame nigga. But I be in that pussy all day, like I'm in the booth. Bitch, I'm the fucking truth.
Now it's yo, Rock and Roll Radio. You already know how we do it every single Wednesday from 7 to 8. You know what I'm saying? We got some surprises here. This is gonna be amazing. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Nah, camera's not even on. Word. But yeah, we in here. You know what I'm saying? You got the NMS screen on.
Right. He said like we got the NMS screen on.
Right. No face on me. There ain't no camera looking at me right now. But, you know, you're hearing the voice and everything. So, you know, that's everything that's legit there.
Definitely. Yeah. Well, this Saturday,
like you said, play is ball. It's going down February 21st. You know
that's
what I'm
right.
saying? For those who don't know, it's
that's
going
right,
down.
That's right. That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Bring on everything because it's going to be a crazy
number
party.
Number five.
Oh, five.
Hit number five.
Blue screen.
No way.
Nah, but anyways, man. You know what I'm saying? The players' ball is going down. You know what I'm saying? Bring your best outfit. It's going to be a crazy party scene. You know
oh,
what
there
saying?
We go. Now we back
you
on.
And, oh, yeah. Now we on here. See now everybody
I'm
can
waving
see
at your camera now.
You know what I'm saying? Hi, guys.
How you guys doing?
NMS Mythology Hour. You already know how we do it every single Wednesday from 7 to 8. It's a beautiful day. Well, I mean
in
a beautiful.
Neighborhood.
Yeah, in the neighborhood.
No, how do you do it?
Oh, how do we do it? Shoot. I mean, it's self-explanatory. You see it on the screen every single Wednesday. And if whoever doesn't see it, I feel sorry for them because, yeah, tune in. Exactly. Because it's crazy. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, anyways, it's going down February 21st. It's going to be a crazy big party at the Howard Johnson Ballroom, Middletown, New York.
Players and playettes.
And yeah, exactly. Players and playettes. Bring your best.
Yeah,
nah,
I see Big Mo's commercial.
No, I didn't actually. Y'all put me on that.
Yeah,
shout out to Big Mo. Maurice Brooks on Facebook. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
He got players, ball.
Yeah, I can imagine how that looks. He probably got all his women with him and stuff, right?
It was like,
yeah. That's look crazy,
it was
man.
Like, it was like,
nah. I was like, oh, shit. I gotta see this show. That's funny. Man, shout out to him though. He got a nice he got some scripts and stuff. He got a movie that just got accepted into Hollywood. So we're definitely gonna shoot a little bit of that in there, and it's gonna be crazy.
And the promoters, that's also there. A reality show that he got going on too.
Yeah,
so that's a big deal too.
Yeah, man.
He got a lot of good
big
stuff.
Mo show. I'm excited about it, man. I'm excited that he's even coming through, and he's gonna bring the funniness, craziness with him.
Oh my God, all kind of people was traveling for that. Like,
and then
Be something real.
And then shout out to the homie Products and the whole Dirty Birds camp and all them. You know, they're coming through too as well. So
Dipset DJs
and all them. So I'm excited for that.
We're going to be probably dropping a couple exclusives that day too. So
yeah, a lot of exclusives. A lot of things that the audience doesn't know. So when you're going to see it at the show. So come along. You know, bring your best outfit. Bring your A game. Bring your swag. You know what I'm saying?
Have a nice plate of food.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? What I mean? It's $25 to get in with a plate of food. And it's $15 to get in without the plate of food. So
all the information is. You got an Eventbrite. Mm-hmm. It's all up now, so you can go and purchase via PayPal, or as well as contacting Lena Shockley on Facebook.
And
On Facebook,
or the
or Twitter,
or the number 845-667-6257.
There you go.
That's reaching directly. And either way, that's the way to get in. You know what I'm saying? No front door. Yo, let me in. Give me nah. We try and have it smooth. Yeah, we try and let it smooth.
That's right.
The time.
Time is important.
Time is important, you know what I'm saying? And we got some special guests here today, you know what I'm saying? We got a whole big camp, you know, shouts to Teresa Kemp and the whole camp and Lynn Rosen and everybody. It's going to be amazing. So I'm excited for that, and I'm excited for what they got to offer and what they got to say today, because it's going to be one of those, you know, those programs where, you know, your eyes will be glued to the screen and you have to pay attention or else you'll miss everything.
Exactly.
So, you know what I'm saying? Stay tuned for that. That's coming on a little bit later, but, you know what I'm saying? Oh yeah, I was about to ask you. You know what I'm saying? My boy Lee Double O. he back in the cut. You know what I'm saying?
Hi.
He back from a long vacation. You know what I'm saying?
That's good, man.
Yo.
What up, though?
Yeah, but he ain't shy to the show, man. He a star. You know what I'm saying? Everybody knows who he is. You know what I'm saying?
Gang.
Yes, you can catch him at the Players Ball.
Gang.
Gang.
Turn the fuck up. Now we fucking do this, man.
NMS Wave Gang, you know what I'm saying? And that's where it starts here. It starts here, man. And this is how we do it, you know what I'm saying? And we got all kind of crazy surprises. My boy Heat for the Creeper, you know what I'm saying? We got everybody,
right,
man. Yo, and Genetics, what up, man? I see you up there in Syracuse, man.
Yeah, we got 4 days till that EP drop, too.
Yeah.
My Life Soundtrack.
Heck, that's
official right there.
So I'm excited
it will
for
be up. Reverb Nation, it will be up for sale. It will be up everywhere.
I'm excited for all these releases, man. All these releases is amazing, and it's going to be cray. Mm-hmm. So, you know, be on the lookout for that.
Definitely.
And, yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's going down. You know what I'm saying? We got a lot of stuff. Also, tune into the website, www.mountaindogentertainment.com. You'll see all kind of exclusives, all kind of new stuff.
Mixtapes.
You know what I'm saying? Mixtapes. It's going down. My mixtape is dropping March 7th, by the way, so that'll be a crazy look.
7.
Yeah, and I got a couple more visuals dropping too very soon as well. So you know, just to get you prepped in and reeled in to the project. Mm. So get a feel of that and get a taste
of
that, and you know, this is the life, man. This is NMS Wave Gang. You know what I'm saying? We got everything going on around here, and I'm excited now. You know what I'm saying? Even more than ever before, because you know, we also got, you know, something coming up in the works, me and Leo. So that's gonna be sick.
Oh my God!
And
yes.
Yeah. There's a lot of surprises in the works, and y'all just gonna feel it and see it. I'm trying to see if we can get have a mixtape release party or something in here. You know what I mean? Just a private little something. Mm. But you know, that's a good setup. We can try to work that out.
Or EP press release.
Either one.
Does that sound bigger?
I'm thinking.
Think about it.
I'm just thinking about it. It's just an idea. It's just a thought. But you know, it will unfold, and you know, yeah, that's what's going down. Uh oh. I hear a lot of people inside out there.
I think
yeah. If so, I'll be like, you know, just waiting for the shock factor. But until then, we're gonna go on a quick break, a quick tiny break,
and quick break.
Don't go nowhere.
Don't you go
NMS
nowhere.
Anthology Hour.
Sit your ass down.
Know what I'm saying? Call in 845-353-2910. That's 845-353-2910. We'll be back.
Yep.
Give me 5 minutes.
mommy.
He said, word to mommy, word to Big Bird.
You are now bumping the sounds of the Wave Gang.
The double O.
So what's up, guys? What's up?
Yeah, what's up?
We
back on deck. Yeah, right.
Awesome.
See, look at that.
I don't know. I'm about to play him at random because you.
Yeah, he knows everyone.
Y'all know what it is.
Just play one. You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Stack!
Gang.
Lead double O.
Gang.
And NWA.
The squad.
With
gang. FTO.
Let's get it.
Around here, nigga, you don't get the fair ones. Yeah. Still from another beat, you can well done. Only give him 2 ways, knife for the gun. So if you like him around here, but you better run. Yeah. Only give him 2 ways, knife for the gun. So if you like him around here, but you better run. That man, stop running, still a honey bun. Gang, I do this for my niggas, you already know. Shout out to the right now. That's how we can pick it, the double O. My never nigga run a point. More, let it blow. Tell her, let it blow. Jamar, let it blow. And it's a mafia party. When Jamar come home, Mel be home soon. Be on his dome. We all young kings chasing after one chase. That money, power, respect with the tech. Living that good life. Foreign bits on deck. I like my cash in front, so what the fuck is a check? And if a nigga my beef for 3 perks to the neck. Word on the street, Leo back now. It's an album like a turtle to a smack ham. I'm Martin East, Dots, you don't like him. No bear, rock a boy, I got the bam bam. I'm gonna show you purple ass niggas who invented swag. Pulled up at the commentary, everything. Pop a tag. Leave a niggas mad. Count racks, what your niggas had. If you Rico for the kilo. Zipping my body bags, body bags, body bags. Zipping my body bags. Gang. Squad. Around here, nigga, you don't get the fair ones. Joe from another beef, you can well done. Only give him 2 ways, knife for the gun. So if you like around here, but you better run. Better run, better run. So if you like around here, but you better run. Better run, better run.
Let's go. Yeah. Squad.
For that work.
Me double O.
Aye. Me double.
RL click.
Oh. Squad.
For that money, for that work. I'm a bird.
I'm a bird.
5 a.m. break a dawn. I'm a bird.
Anytime.
With my niggas pulling triggers. I'm a bird. Chasing guap at the top. I'm a bird.
Yeah,
yeah.
First word, I'm a burley. Fuck a bitch, I'm getting money over pussy. I'm a legend in this game, your niggas rookie. From the school of hard night, never play no hooky. I'm flexing on your little niggas, no jam. You can't get a dollar out of me, bitch, I am a pimp. I'm ballin' on you niggas above the rim. Shootin' threes in my 23s on Space Jam. I'm a right name on this bridge. I'm Charlie Sheen and on them, I can never lose. I'm used to winning. As I stack my wonder bread, boy, I see you greedy pigeons. For that money, for that work. Fiends early, I see these bitches thirsty. Leo, Leo, these bitches love Leo, but I see right through these thoughts. All they want is my dinero. I'm going off, it's time to go ham. I keep 2 pistols on my side, Yosemite Sam. Fuck around and make your bear rock shooters go bam bam. The way I'm stacking this guap, got them like damn. I'll be flexing on Instagram. 1, 2, 3, 400 grand. I'm up, up in the way, and I pray I don't land. Every night feel like the early morning.
Happy New Year, nigga.
Chopper spinning around, tornado.
I got hella motherfucking Play-Doh. Ay, lead devil. Ay, squat. Dinero, I'm chasing at the bands. I'm living in the naked, all that body in a big casino. If a nigga want beef, I give him shell no time. Choppers better ride around. Tornado. Wiz Khalifa, Amber Rose, my new diva. All the niggas catching buzz of beats. On my road to riches in my new Toyota. I'm switching lanes with my chopper. My shorty bad, but she talk proper. I'm not a smart but to a papa. She let me check that pussy like I'm a doctor. NBA jamming, I'm shakalaka. If I think I want my dick sucked, shorty say I gotcha. Dinero, I'm chasing at the bands. I'm living in the biggie, all that pop in a big casino. If a nigga
wants Young Kiko.
First off, shout out to Young Kiko, man. Wave gang in a mess, we out here. RL Click the Militia.
My nigga shoot back, when we see you it's a rap. Put the red beat to your head, take your body on the map. Nines and baseball bats, 40 snakes and rats. Try to multiply, and you'll get subtracted. Erase your ass on the map, boy, I ride around strap. Got that Mac on my lap with the war pack ready to attack. My nigga shoot back, when we see you it's a rap. Put the red beat to your head, but you pull your stacks. Nines and baseball bats, 40 snakes and rats. Try to multiply, and you'll get subtracted. Erase your ass on the map, boy, I ride around strap. Got that Mac on my lap with the war pack ready to attack. My nigga shoot back. Got a nigga with that Miami heat. I chop your head off, leave your body in the streets. Kidnap your daughter, down the indoor pitch. Make your mom drink with some more psycho shit. I ain't never give a fuck, I ain't never give a fuck. Run over your house in a monster truck. I gave drug a love like a sister at home. Watching in the backseat, giving my bro drive. I'm the Hell's Kitchen flipping devil's weight. Throwing dead bodies in Chevrolet. Hoover and Mikey better recognize. Out here on well blockers, do or die. Catch your eye block and shoot on sight. Little more, leaving dead at the light. Call a girl, now she wanna spend the night. Only want the top, I ain't trying to pipe. Big niggas tryna act real, putting up a front for a record deal. Clown ass nigga never in the field. Never held a shoddy nigga who you kill. Never had a hustle on a block that pay mama love rent bill. You a snitch nigga, lips ain't still. I bury your body on Silent Hill. Real recognize real, and nah, nah, fake feel. My chopper go ring-a-tang when I feed it banana pills. For the love of Buffalo Bills, why gang we in the field? Double tied the front one time, police want me killed. I be on world block, posted up, stinging rocks, getting paid, pot o'clock, middle finger to the cop, diddy bop, on the op, see, I the same, popping Bernese, toy, sold it back in they toy box, 400, that's a case, outside, tell the sky, niggas with a four, got you fucking with a world block, call up, red dot, now you got red dots all over the body, like you caught a fucking chicken pox. Shoot back, when we see you, it's a rat, put the red beam to your hat, take your body off the mat, knives and baseball bat.
Lee double. Oh.
Like nigga, what you say? Like nigga, what you say? Like nigga, what you say? Get him, 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 get him
get the fuck out my face. What my name in your mouth, you must like the way it takes. And I'm pissing that niggas, my bullets do erase. Out after my lawyer, we just beat another case. Gotta keep the pole on me just in case. I don't do much when I don't like the fucking chase. But I do let my doors out the motherfucking cage. All the combat flow, finish if I tell the what's up? When I come through, I'm masked out, jumping out my sunroof. You can catch a hole in one like gumballs. I treat it off like Pokemon, I gotta catch them all. What's up? Real nigga, I'm above the law. Kidnapping the field, strapped up, so watch me and my money dance. When my pockets hella thick, when my MC talk damn, boy, I'm too legit to quit. Bug you and your family when I see you. It's a rat on sight. No talk, get your wig pushed back. You a fool to me, nigga. Welcome to the wolf pack. You a hoe, any streets, you can get pissed. Like, nigga, what you say? Don't make me have to kick in your door, leave you dead in your living room floor. Like, nigga, what you say? I don't try to be for internet war, red cell base, gotta be a contract. Like, nigga, what you say? The one to the two to the D4. Yeah, my niggas like you. I don't see you, I'ma drop your hoes. I'ma drop you, niggas, I'ma drop you. Stick 'em, 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 get 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 'em. Bear down on your head like a Hindu. Click clap, brr, and now you're light through. Dude, tryna get away in my Nike boots. Back to the studio, smoking in the booth. I'm like, I
want to
beat, all I say is who, what,
where, when, why, I just came from the mall, it's the edge of the fly,
nigga.
Yes, 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 we are. Hey!
This
is the let me see the shirt. Let me see the shirt.
You see it's backwards.
Yo,
right?
yo.
Yeah, hold on. That is.
You this see it's backwards. But when you look in the mirror, she's selling shirts. It says damaged goods. Damaged goods.
Oh,
these
see,
are
I
35
see
t-shirts or 25.
She's like, can you sell it?
That's the boss
yes.
man there.
Yes, yes, yes.
I
yes, yeah. Introduce
and
me. Because I need it.
George.
Yeah.
Then I leave and then George comes on.
Okay.
Yeah, no, definitely, man. I was looking forward to this definitely interview. So introduce me here and tell me what you got going on here.
This is cool.
Okay, my name is Lynn Rosen. I'm from Lynn's Kids. Woohoo!
Okay.
I'm from Saving Souls. Where we save souls all over the world. I haven't saved mine yet, but that's okay.
Okay.
And I'm also for Authors for Causes, and that's one of the main reasons that I'm here. Mm. We have camps all over the world. If you're listening, Alu. Hello. We have camps in Ghana. Go ahead,
oh,
Teresa,
this is
help
wow.
us out here. We have camps
Morocco,
in
Morocco, Sierra Leone, USA. We're getting ready to open up
India
in,
and Saduka right. and so Vinu.
Cool. Okay.
We're getting ready to open up in Jamaica.
Ooh.
Oh, that's good. So,
okay. And I'm also an author, and I write for causes. And that's the reason I was asked to come on the show.
Okay.
For many years, I might look like, oh my God, like she doesn't have a problem in the world. I have plenty of problems. I'd probably be one of the homeless because all my money goes to these camps.
Oh, okay.
Oh, wow.
I was abused verbally for 3 years by a gentleman who is a pig.
Mm-hmm.
He never
Hi.
Touched me.
Hi.
You
know you're watching.
Hello. Lived in Morocco.
Morocco.
And my next book, which is called The Dirtbag Diary, has actually
Ooh.
A big, huge
wow.
dartboard with his picture in the middle.
Dartboard.
I invite you to our conference, and we're going to throw darts at him.
Oh, man.
So, at him or the board, it doesn't matter.
Oh, this is cool.
I hope you hit him because I really don't care
what a dollar dart.
A dollar dart.
A dollar dart. There you go.
Dollar dart. I see. I dig
and
it.
In the background with the noisy here, Mama T. This is a poem I wrote about abuse because, you know what? For 3 years, I stuck to this jerk.
Uh-huh.
And the reason I did was because I really believed I loved him. He had a wife that never stopped me. He never even held my hand. So, hey,
wow.
I'm clean.
That's crazy.
But, yeah, isn't it? No, it's not crazy. I'm glad I would have had a disinfectant.
Yeah. Yeah, right?
There you go.
No,
she's right. She's right.
Thank you, God.
Wouldn't want to cross-contaminate.
Hallelujah.
Okay, so I wrote a poem saving no and saying no. And this is exactly what it is for any woman who has been abused. I was abused verbally. He told me my books are worth nothing, and I have books for you that I'll give you before I go home.
Okay.
He told me my books are stupid. As soon as I got rid of him, and it's because of this lady over here, T, I actually got out of the abuse because I was able to feel confident enough to realize that when you are physically abused, you see scars. When you're verbally abused, there are no scars. So I don't know which is worse, but no woman has to stand for any man's crap. Excuse me. And right?
True.
Okay.
So you're right.
You're nice to the people who
yes.
you're dealing with. I don't want to ever hear I know where you live. Okay, I'm going to ask Teresa to read this because I don't have my glasses.
Neither do I. I'll try my best. Okay. Say no. If I choose to look nice today, does that mean you should take me and have your way? Have your way with me however you desire. To be raped is like walking through fire. Rape, either vicious act of crime. It is like being imprisoned and doing time.
Exactly.
The victim is made to feel like the accused. Living with this for the rest of your life is not what anyone would choose. More?
Yes.
Wow. Oh, okay. Sorry. You scream and say no. He pumps harder and lets the semen flow. Tears keep dripping down it's your true. Face. Being raped is something you can never erase. Never forget this message, my friends. Create awareness to the end. If a woman dresses sexy, it doesn't mean she says yes. It means she likes the way she looks. This I must confess. We are living in a society where men do score. Important people get away with rape and so much more. Remember this and remember it well. Each victim has a horrible story to tell. Get out there and advocate. Fight for the victims that cops often berate. Never forget, as my words do flow, the important thing is she said no.
Mm. Now, when, thank you.
Wow.
Thank you. Woo-hoo! Okay, when, for Authors for Causes is a new for-profit. I usually do none, that's why I have no money.
Okay.
But Authors for Causes is a for-profit because we're going to take that money and put it into rape programs for people, give them a place to live where they feel they have a place to go. So my partner in that is Rashad Kareem, who wanted to come here with me, but he had something else to do.
Okay.
Lynn's Kids is about helping children all through the world, and I have to mention The Wind Beneath My Wings, my mentor Saduka Malpe. I know I'm probably saying his name wrong. Saduka Malpe taught me, when this man pulled me down to the garbage, that I was made of something that I was worth fighting for. Vinod Bhatanka, who is my other mentor, he taught me to just go for it and forget about all the nonsense. Just go for it, hit the bullseye, and help children. So now we have like over 20 camps all over the world helping children.
Hold that thought. We got
some are riding camps.
We have a call.
Oh, okay. That must be Richard.
You live and direct. You live and direct.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey, who we speaking with? Oh man. Yeah.
Okay.
Listening, whoever you are.
Okay. In any case, Saving Souls gets out there to soup kitchens. And we're helping people, and that's going to be the program that's really going to be talking about abuse of all kinds. So we have Teresa here. Uh-huh. So, but we're fighting for Lynn's Kids. We're fighting for Saving Souls. If you want to donate to help people who are raped, go to savingsouls.net/. Okay. And Teresa, do you want to talk about a different kind of abuse? So I talked about verbal abuse. Somebody makes you feel like 1 foot tall.
Rock and roll.
You live and direct. Rock and roll radio, you live and direct.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh. Okay.
Wow. Well, I am.
No, I guess people are playing with the phones now. So okay,
there
well.
Are so many different ways of different things of abuse. It's physical, psychologically, financially. Okay, and there's so much more.
Right.
I was once that victim. Yes, I was once that little girl. I was once that teenager. Yes, I was once that woman. But, okay, I mean, God didn't look at me for my degrees, for my diplomas. He looked at me for my scars. And I want to let all you women know out there, okay, Never let a man, okay, try to take control over you.
Exactly.
And the same thing, there are men out there that are being abused, but same because thing, of their matter. Manhood, mm-hmm. don't let no woman take advantage of you. You both, it's 50-50, okay? Now, I have no teeth in the back of my mouth. This eye, it's my eye, but it's a mechanical eye. My eyelashes, you're looking like if it's my eyelashes, but it's not. My arm here, okay? This is from a gunshot, okay, from my daughter's father. Okay, I got marks on my body. I was left for dead. I was kidnapped. But you know what? I kept my faith in God. You see what I'm saying? And
never give up.
That's a right. man That's right. can beat you like they did me. Oh, baby, I'm sorry. What's I love you. No. You don't love me. Okay, when I was a little kid, okay, a little girl living in mommy's house, my real father lived down the block. Okay, I was 6 years old. I was being abused and raped by my mother's boyfriend, okay? My real father lived down the block, okay? My mother was getting abused by my boyfriend, by her boyfriend, okay? I had to keep my mouth shut, okay? My father went to his grave not knowing the man who did this.
Wow.
Okay, and I know, Daddy, you're That's up in right. heaven. I love you. Rest in peace. You know, but I know my father's turning over. You know, you men out there, okay, respect your woman. Respect mm-hmm. your queen.
That's right.
Okay, and vice versa. Women, respect your man. You have a good man, you stick by his side.
Mm-hmm.
But if you come to an argument or whatever, yeah, sometimes, you know, us women that we've been through abuse like me, I have a wall there, okay? And that wall is always going to be there. So just like I love my boyfriend, Mark, I love you dearly. Lynn can tell you, he's a sweetheart. Wonderful. You know, sometimes I get in my mood swings because I'm afraid. I'm still afraid of putting my feelings out. I tell him I love him. He knows I love him. But at the same time, I'm afraid of getting hurt. Mm-hmm. You know, and there are certain things in the relationship that your new partner would do, okay, and say that it would automatically put you to the past, mm-hmm. you know. But with him, he has talking to me. And so on and so forth. And that's why I respect him, because he's helping me to bring that wall down more.
Good.
You know, and I'm here to help you other women out there. Okay, because if a man tells you he loves you, and I'm going to say this, and I respect all mothers out there, but you men, if you say, and we see how you treat your mother, the queen that she is.
Exactly.
If you can't treat your woman and show your woman the respect how you treat your mother, then sorry. Okay. We don't need you.
Yeah. Exactly. You see no, what I'm she's saying? Right. She's absolutely right. Right.
She's actually right about that.
She's
this
right.
is what I tell any man. You treat me like the queen I am, I'll treat you
like the king,
like the king that you are.
Yep.
You
want or the king that you should be. Yeah. Or the king that you okay. should be.
Exactly. Look, yeah.
If you want to play me like a game, I'm going to show you how it's played.
Exactly.
Okay? That's exactly. me.
She ain't playing no game.
You know? Let's get George up here.
George?
Okay. George is going to be doing a special program to help women that are in this position. And I want to give him a few minutes to be able to talk. If you leave it to Teresa and I, we'll forget all about it.
No, I see. So y'all have a lot to say.
Right,
that's
right. Yeah,
y'all
got a lot going on. Yeah, we do.
He's a pastor.
Saving
He's a
Souls. If you want to contribute, savingsouls.net/. You listening, Michael? We're talking, and then we're going to get into veterans. Don't worry, Michael.
Yeah, veterans.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, let me get an extra mic on here.
There you go.
Yeah.
That's for you.
We're talking about the program.
Full House, right?
Yeah.
Good evening, everyone. My name is George. I'm a pastor, a Protestant pastor, and I'm just honored to be here with the whole thing
yes.
with Lynn and Teresa.
Okay, we know that. Just get to the point.
Try to take the call, and let's see if there's somebody okay. calling in for these people here.
Oh.
Yeah, they just stopped just now.
Okay, go ahead.
Just go ahead. Basically, I'll be doing, working with Lynn and Teresa with literacy and helping women, disadvantaged women and women that are abused, to help get themselves on their feet educationally, academically, and also career-wise. You know, people go through a lot of things, and we want to support them and undergird them with their self-esteem, with helping them with careers and education and self-esteem. And there'll be plenty of more things, but that's the main thing.
Okay. Okay. Great, George. Very good. Mm. Okay, so Authors for Causes, my little kids from PS 135. Okay, yep. That could be him. Ready to tell me stuff.
Really, you live and direct.
Hello?
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 Okay. Right. In any case, my children are writing about veterans. You want to know why they're writing about veterans? Because we think that all of these places give the veterans money that they're supposed to give them. Absolutely not. Mm-hmm. What they do is they give them a certain percentage of what. So when we're giving people money on the street or out there, and the book is in, I'm going to show you the book that I have. The book that my children wrote, I didn't write it. I'm not as good as they are. They wrote a book called Veterans, Love the Veterans, Hug the Veterans, because they know about veterans.
Because their families.
Right, their families have veterans. Mm-hmm. And the point is that when I hear that a place only gives 54% of what they make to the veterans, I ask myself, what's happening to the other percentages? Mm. Some places are only giving 30-something percentages. So I just want you all out there to know, hello, New York. I always want to say that. I just want you to all know that this crazy lady here, there is no way you're going to get away with hurting veterans. Veterans were on the front line. They supported us.
Exactly.
So Authors for Causes is saving supporting soldiers. Veterans. Saving Souls is supporting veterans. We're going to speak to Sergeant Gale next week, and he's going to come to my school to honor my children who did fabulous books. Mm. And no one is going to cheat veterans. We're also going under Women's Emancipation. Isn't it about time?
Yeah.
Definitely about time.
And we're fighting every cause, like closing libraries. Can you imagine closing libraries? Yeah,
but that's not good. That's I don't agree with that at all. I really don't. I was trying to figure that out too. When I heard about
closing libraries, Carolyn McIntyre, I didn't forget you, honey. I'm just talking a lot. And I'm trying to breathe in between, Carolyn.
Taking money out of her pocket to reopen libraries.
I wrote about 8 books about libraries. My children wrote. My favorite book is Are You Kidding Me? That was the title.
That's cool.
And they said, how can you take away our library? Our library is the doorway to knowledge. You know why they're taking it away? Because they want all of us in the dark ages.
Yeah.
Because then a dumb consumer won't fight them. You hear that, Bill de Blasio? This is all your fault.
There you go.
You hear that, Bill? I'm coming after you.
Yeah, go chop heads off.
Okay, and in one of the books my children wrote, Dear Bill, can I call you Bill?
Can I call you Bill?
That's funny.
And they wrote, Dear Bill, why are you closing my library? Doesn't Dante need a library? I love that. I thought that was really cool. I said, no, he needs a place to do his hair.
What's your overall mission statement?
My mission statement is to help New York in any way we can, especially the children. The children are our future.
I agree. Yes.
The children are our future.
That is so true.
I am out there with Lynn's Kids, Saving Souls, and Authors for Causes, fighting for those kids every damn day of the week. Mm. Forgive me, George. I cursed about 4 times.
No. It's all good. You gotta.
Whatever.
Sometimes I curse.
Okay. In any case, the whole point is that I'm fighting for any child. And to be perfectly honest, if we educate the mothers, they will teach the sisters and the brothers.
That's right.
Exactly. Each one teach one.
And one thing I want to say, because I have my own entertainment company. Okay. All you entertainers out there, okay, you need, because remember this, you have your children.
That's right.
Okay, you have children. Okay, you're out here singing, okay, and all you big timers out there that have all this money, okay, even you upcoming artists,
Don't only focus on yourself.
Focus on Lynn's kids.
Focus on the future, and those are the kids.
Exactly.
Our children out there.
Our mission is to help out every child all singing, over the world.
You're entertaining.
Sell your Bentley and open up a library in your house.
Go to libraries. Go to your community centers. You know, speak to the owners, the bosses, whatever, and see how you can get involved with the kids, because the kids would look up to you.
That's right.
Close
you
the
see
library.
What I'm saying?
How you,
exactly.
You talk, how do you close a library? Now, one of my kids said something about, well, it really hurts my mother. And I said, why does it hurt your mother? And he said, because my mother can't take me to the library.
There you go.
And my mother comes home too late at night. And it's not that she doesn't care, but she can't get me there.
Wow.
So what happened is that my school library closed. I found out that my school library closed because I had retired. I'm no longer retired. Uh-huh. But I reopened the library. I brought in my staff, and I reopened the library. How do you close a school library?
A school library. No, I didn't know they were going that far.
Yes.
School libraries.
So I reopened the library in the Super School of PS 135. Woohoo! It was a fun place. And I'm telling all you retired teachers out there, if you're sitting on your buns, I won't use the word, because Father George is Pastor George. He doesn't want to be called Father. In any case, I won't use that word. But in any case, what I am saying is get off your buns and get out there and go into a school and say, do you need my help?
Exactly.
If the Board of Education paid for your salary all these years, give back to those children, because if they don't have a school library, shame on you for sitting home or sunning in Florida. Get out there and help everyone.
That's right.
That's what it's about.
Okay, I agree. I like that. So, like, when they, all these libraries closing down and all that stuff like that, does it go with, like, the voting and everything, too? Like, people are not getting out there enough to vote?
Closing public assets is what it's all about.
Okay.
So we have all these big wigs.
Yeah.
Okay, you hear that, Bill D?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm coming after you.
Yeah.
We have all those big wigs. It all started with Mayor Mike.
Okay.
His name, when even I say it, I feel like throwing up. But in any case, Mayor Mike, who decided that, okay, he had all these billions, let's close everything out. Closing hospitals, how dare you?
Closing hospitals, wow.
Hello, wow. Welcome to, you know,
protect the kids and not the millionaires.
Right,
that's
exactly.
That's right.
And how about giving tax breaks to those fat-ass millionaires? Regular people are getting nothing. Paying taxes because of those jackasses who don't have to pay.
Yeah.
How right is that? Aren't you sorry?
That's crazy.
I love it.
No.
We love it too.
No, we love this. No, we love
this. She gotta let it out.
You gotta let it out. This is the perfect show to do it on.
I am sick of New York. I am sick that we are a third world nation. I am sick that we have become, we have people hungry in the streets.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay, there's a call.
There you go.
See that? Get that
call. Rock and roll radio.
You live in that wreck.
Hello?
Okay.
What is up with this?
Okay, forget it.
This never happens.
We're not answering no more calls for the rest of the show, because you guys is playing.
Okay. Yeah. Now, I want to say hello to Mubarak Akhadar, who is coming in, and I invite everybody here. There are two of you. Everybody here to come to Lynn's Kids International Conference on July 13th and 14th in Manhattan. Meet all my international partners. For some reason, Mubarak calls himself Tiger Mammal. He has some identity problem. Is he a tiger? I mean, is he going to bite? I mean, watch him roar. Well, in any case, hi, Mubarak. My point is that we're here to help everybody.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be children. But we're basically out because if we save the children, we'll have a better tomorrow. What kind of legacy are we leaving the children if we close libraries?
Exactly.
What kind of legacy are we leaving the children if kids are sitting with 40 kids in a class?
Yeah,
exactly.
How do you learn like that?
It's crumpled. Like it's all.
Then there was a new thing with the Board of Ed talking down to teachers. Teachers are so terrible. Meanwhile, teachers aren't terrible. The teachers in PS 135 give 180% of themselves, and so do teachers in every other school I deal with.
Because there's a lot of Ed, there's a lot of good teachers out here.
Let's not think of the bad ones. Think of the good ones.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now, the Board of Ed is blaming everybody else, but you, the people of the Board of Ed, need to do a better background check.
You go get them.
Okay?
There you
because
go.
Look
right.
at
right.
how many of these teachers the Board of Education is hiring, and they're molesting our children.
There you
okay?
go.
And then you, the Board of Education and CWS, okay, and society, want to come down on us good parents, mm-hmm. okay, yeah. and the good teachers. Because let me tell you something. Ain't no government of New York or out of New York, if my child is not getting the proper education and is getting abused in the in the educational system, trust me, okay? It's going to be fire against fire because I would take my child out of that school and keep my butt home and teach my child from home.
Homeschool.
Okay?
You know what I'm saying? Homeschool. like how it was.
I don't blame you.
So step up to the plate, Board of Education, because the children are our future. Mm-hmm. And you have kids home. Yeah. Okay? That's so it. Let's get it together. Yeah, let's get it together.
100%. And the point is, if you were better to today's teachers, instead of giving them $55.
Yeah, right? That too.
No, I agree with that.
10 minutes in a store. Duh. So what Lynn's Kids does is Lynn's Kids give supplies to schools that become Lynn's Kids schools.
Mm. Yeah.
That's why I'll be one of the hungry one day. But in any case, we are here to help all the I'm so glad I'm making you lift. Maybe I should go on Comedy Central.
No, this is good.
We are here to help all teachers and all schools.
Yes.
And you want to become a Lynn's Kids school? Just go to Saving Souls, leave a message, savingsouls.net/. And Michael Noble, if you're watching, I didn't mention the veterans you didn't want me to mention. I might think about it. In any case,
I might think about it.
And he will get back to you and refer it to me. And you can become a Lynn's Kids school. All you have to do is care about kids.
That's right.
I went into a school. Now, I tell you, I love PS 135 because I taught there for 25 years.
And they write a lot of the books with me.
Right, loads of books. I'll show you the books later. But I went into a school the other day, which made me realize I never saw a school like this. It's IS 62. I did a New York Cares project. Let's hear it for New York Cares.
There you go.
I did a New York Cares project for them. Fabulous project. Fabulous. And it's called Coffee and Conversation.
Huh.
Now, the principal's name is Barry Kevorkian, say nothing. And every teacher in the school loves the principal. I mean, he makes that school, it is just like such a, like, welcome to the school. You want to be in a school like that. You want to get your children into schools where you have a principal that greets you at the door. You want to get your children into schools where you see a happy atmosphere. And we're here to help all those children. We're here to make it a better tomorrow, one without sorrow.
And can I say one thing?
You can say everything.
This is to all the parents out there. Okay, a lot of the children sometimes act up. They don't want to do their homework, or they're just plain acting up when it comes to their classwork or their schoolwork or whatever. Take time out. Don't put your child under punishment.
Rock and Roll Radio, you live and direct.
I'm just not going to waste my time picking up a phone. Take time out and sit down, okay, with your child.
I guess we're not. Yeah, exactly.
Right?
Sit down and talk to your child, because I've noticed a lot of parents are blaming their children for what's going on with their education.
Really? A lot of it is in the home.
There you go.
No, but I've been to some schools where I've done presentations, okay? And like I said, get up. You have every right. Okay, you can go to your child's school. You don't have to make an appointment. Stand on the side. Because in every school, there's good teachers, there's bad teachers, the guidance counselors, and so on and so forth. When there's parents' meetings, get your butt up and go to the parents' meetings, okay? When your child has an event in school, get up. Get off your butt. Go and support your child in the school.
It was butt.
Because by you showing this, it's showing your child that you care. I know what it is being in school and you're looking out there in the audience. You see everybody else's parents except for your own. Okay. If there's two of you in the household, trust me, Mm-hmm. Okay? One of you can get up and do it. Either one of you can get off work early. Yeah, bills have to be paid. Food on the table. Mm-hmm. Okay? But don't forget where your child come from.
That's right.
Okay? Get out there. You parents, support your children. Because if you don't support them, the streets are. That's why there's a lot of gangs. All this, we need after school programs. Obama, hello. Cuomo, hello. We need back our after school programs, and we need to bring prayers back into our education, not schools.
Make sure you pick a president who cares about education, not fracking.
And racism.
Do not pick Hillary. She cares about fracking. That's all I'm going to say about her.
Fracking.
She works with fracking. Okay,
she said fracking.
The boy who took us. We want to thank.
She like to put people out of the table. She's like, hold on. What's
Jeff, right? A driver? Yeah.
We want to thank Jeff for taking us here. And Jeff is available.
And Lena.
And Jeff.
That's his
son. There you go.
He's like single. He's adorable.
He's 35 years old. He wants a woman older than 35. So, ladies, you have to like cars. You have to be into sports. You have to be active. She was drilling him in. You know? Don't look at me in the cars. I'm on.
Hold it down. Hold it down.
She's an hour already spoken.
Hold it down.
I love you, baby. I love you a lot.
Hold it down. Yay, hold it down. Oh my God, that was funny. That was funny.
God is not letting me go, baby. We may have our difficulties, but we're team. Oh no, I gotta say one thing.
Yeah. Squeeze it.
Let me.
Yeah. I was about to ask you about that too.
Let me pause. My hair may look messy, but let me. I'm the model for my boyfriend's son, soon to be my son-in-law. You see these sweatshirts? We have t-shirts.
Yeah, there you go.
Can you read it backwards? You know, can you just say what?
We got 10 more minutes.
Okay,
oh, so
come on,
this
Teresa.
Is called damaged goods. When you look in the mirror, you see damaged goods.
Nothing damaged
your hoodies,
about you.
Yeah, I was like, they're not damaged much.
The t-shirts are 25.
Okay.
You can go, real quick. You can go to damagedgoods.
I love this too.
newyork.bigcartel.com. Again, go to damagedgoodsnewyork.bigcartel.com or you can link me up. 35 for the sweats and 25 for the shirts. Love you. See, I'm pausing it.
I like the way that looks though.
Okay.
That's a different
thing. Ladies and gentlemen, I always wanted to say hello. Okay. If you have somebody that is abused in your family.
Yes.
If you have somebody, also Lynn's Kids is doing counseling. We're also doing after school tutoring.
And we also help
for parents who cannot
inmates,
afford. Okay, yeah.
Inmates.
Well, we haven't started that yet. Who cannot afford. We're also going to have what we call a transitional program from when people get out of prison. To make it easier for them.
Right.
And it's a transition program, and we're going to be counseling them and trying to find them jobs. You just don't take somebody out of prison and say, okay, get back to the real world. Hello, I'm Bobby. Yeah. It doesn't work.
It doesn't
and
work.
And then blacklist them.
And then blacklist them, right?
Blacklist them.
Like, for what?
And then they can't get a job.
You have to get out.
Then they end up going back to the streets.
To
and back in the cell.
Just because
back
they
in
the
cell.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
If
yes.
God can forgive them, so can
you. So can you.
Exactly.
Yeah,
that's right.
Exactly.
I like
so
that.
We want to say thank you very much, dear. Are you free too? Do you need a girl?
She said, yeah. Like, yeah. Everybody noticed it. Yeah.
Oh, no. Nah. I'm about to go. I'm good. Okay. Yeah, I know.
Okay. So,
Lena, we love you, baby.
I love you guys too. Okay, but we wanted to tell you that Lynn's Kids is willing to come to your school and help to get supplies, to work with teachers, to really, really have a good time.
And where are you from originally?
Oh no, I'm originally from the Bronx, but
okay.
I'm everywhere. We're vagabonds. We
we're
travel.
Both, yeah, we're brothers. We're actually brothers. A lot of people don't know that.
Oh,
I don't know how,
in
but.
BK in the house.
Oh, Brooklyn?
Yeah,
okay.
In the house.
Oh, let me find out.
Okay. What is this, Springfield?
Spring Valley.
We all out here.
Interested in you have an area if you're from Bangladesh. You know,
yeah, we have a camp in Bangladesh.
UK, wherever.
Yeah.
Well, my question is, who is, how did y'all get so widespread, though? Like, so worldwide with it?
Okay. Yeah. I'm going to answer that question.
Yeah, how did y'all?
A man named Alison Kamara. Hi,
Alan. Hi,
Alan. had a dream. He's in Sierra Leone, which is surrounded with poverty. Al had a dream that we would help every child in the world. So we opened up for my birthday many, many years ago.
This is cool.
And plus he gave me Lynn's kids. Mm-hmm. I said to myself, okay, one camp. I'm a high roller. I said, well, you know, it didn't cost me anything at the time. And then I decided, well, if you have Lynn's kids, Sierra Leone, what about the rest of the world? Yeah. And somebody said to me, why are you helping kids in Sierra Leone? What about New York? I said, I'm helping everybody.
There you go.
So we wound up opening Lynn's Kids New York because we have a lot of poverty here.
Yeah.
Then countries started to do it. In the beginning, I used to fund them. Now I don't. I just send supplies because they should be able to operate by themselves.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah, but I send my books, my kids' books. I send any supplies I get that I feel they could use. In fact, I got a shipment of computers that are on their way to Sierra Leone.
Oh, good.
That's wonderful.
To Mubarak.
Yes.
In Morocco. Mm-hmm. And to Alo in Sierra Leone. And I will help anybody who shows me that they want to work. If you want to camp and you're just thinking you want to camp because you want to get things, you're with the wrong person. My mom didn't raise any dumb blondes.
Yeah.
You have to show me. You see the roots?
You have to also email us your plan on what your plans are for the kids.
Activities,
everything.
I will not take you if you say I want to camp. That does nothing. Show me, what are you going to do for my kids?
What are you going to do to make a difference?
You got
to
be actually active. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right. Mm-hmm. I had activity plans that a person gave me from
Ghana.
Yeah, that really, my two-year-old could write a better activity plan. Wow. So we turned down that camp. We have activity plans that Richard did from Ghana, which were absolutely fabulous. And we have plans that Alu did, which were fabulous. And we have Hassan's plan that was excellent. We have Mubarak's plan that was excellent. Most of my people do plans that show you. Now we have Dr. Vinod Bhatanka, who was my mentor, who was in India in the water, literally.
Wow.
And what he does is he purifies the water. He's also a Reiki master, so if you need your body healed, he will heal
right
it.
Here, baby.
Wow. Woo!
Take us away like cow.
She said right here.
Okay. Then we have Sudhakar Malpi, who is my other mentor. He is the wind beneath my wings, and I would be really, really sad if I didn't mention him. We have wonderful camp directors in every country. We have the international facilitator for Authors for Causes. First, we hired a facilitator who didn't facilitate.
Mm.
So, the same one with the dartboard, you know, bing.
You're right, same thing.
Now we have a facilitator from Bangladesh.
And I want to know if we could give the preacher the mic so we could find out a little bit more about his...
Yes. Your church.
Okay, here we go. This is Pastor George.
Pastor George.
This is an exciting evening. Basically, what I've been doing for the better part of a couple of decades now, between 20, 25 years or 30 years, is actually doing academic youth mentoring. And I have a business partner, and what we do, we have created a model that employs, academic youth mentoring, helping kids get into college, and also tutoring with sports.
Wow.
So whether the kids like basketball, football, baseball, basketball, soccer, volleyball, that's the caveat. But the real thing we do is preparing kids for college and careers. And so to date, we've helped several different young people, and we're hoping to take this program throughout the city, the five boroughs, and then beyond.
Yes. Okay.
Now, I like the sound of that.
Yeah. That sounds good.
I really do.
We want to, for instance, take some of these young people that are working in Division I, II, and III programs in sports, but also... also make them academicians, because, you know,
I don't want to say this, but I have to say it. We want to
take the kids out of this whole thing of these dumb classes they used to give the athletes back in the old days, and they could just go to school and make billions of dollars for the NCAA or whatever programs.
Oh, I got you.
But we want to make them really responsible. For instance, I just heard a story about Shaquille O'Neal that I didn't know. His mother is a very educated person.
Yeah.
She's a PhD. But did you know that Shaquille O'Neal has his MBA and he has his doctorate?
Yes.
So we want to, we want to keep kids away. We want to steer kids away from this whole thing of staying online in these stores, getting $300, $400, and $500 sneakers
and telephones,
and telephones and materialism, and teach them that being in the school library or research center is cool.
Yeah.
I think Huey Lewis had a song years ago, "It's Hip to Be Square." So it's not all about the materialism and these other things, but it's about getting education in your brain.
Getting an education
and then doing like Magic Johnson or Shaquille O'Neal, that literally a James Brown. There was a reason why the late James Brown was called the hardest working man in show business, because he was literally hiring people and creating black businesses all over America and around the world.
That's
so
a beautiful
we
want to
take
right
our children in the inner city and teach them how to create your own brand and be your own business entrepreneur.
That's
what Pastor George is all about. And my friend, Mr. Christopher, amen.
And always remember, no matter how much of a good sportsman you is during your teenager years, but just remember, it's always good to have a plan B and a plan C. Because you're into the athlete. Okay, let's say you become a good basketball player or a soccer player, whatever. But things happen, you get injured, your career is over.
It's true.
Okay.
Happens to your next plan.
Don't pay mind to these people out here. Oh, don't worry about your education. We're
going to
sign you. No, you tell them, I know I'm good, but my education comes first.
That's it.
Exactly.
And you walk away.
Don't let them chew you up like you're the pit of a fruit.
Exactly.
You know?
That's what they
just
will
remember,
do
if you need us, Lynn's Kids, Sins and Souls, and Authors for Cause.
And do you guys have like a Twitter, Facebook, anywhere they can
follow
you guys?
Oh, are you kidding me? I tweet every day.
There
that's
go.
What I'm talking
it's
about.
I want to follow you. I need to follow y'all.
I went from 100 tweets to 354 followers. Yes. We have Lynn's Kids is on Facebook. Authors for Causes is on Facebook, and Saving Souls. And Saving Souls really has my heart, because Saving Souls is the one that gets out there for the victims of abuse.
And homeless.
And for those, you know, the problem with rape and abuse is that very often the police make you feel like you're the person who did the wrong thing.
Wow.
That's why I wrote She Said No, because we wrote a book together, all of us, Hands Up, Don't Shoot, about our wonderful police.
Yeah.
How
about that?
Our marvelous police force. I would rather be with my ex-husband than be with the police.
Woo!
Exactly.
And that means a lot.
That
really does mean
real
a lot.
Real talk.
Today, how dare you be worried about the police? That I would be worried if I were pulled over. Who knows what they would do?
Mm-hmm.
So we have to be able to defend ourselves against our police. We have to be able to defend ourselves against men, women, etc. If you're raped and you're a man, I'm here to help you too.
That's right.
It's not only about women. I'm here to help anybody who is a victim. But don't go back to that person who victimized you. It took me 3 years to walk away from that jerk.
Right.
3 years. But you know what? I didn't have the scars to show anybody. So nobody knew that I was victimized. All he ever said to me was, I need this and I need that. And I supplied. But he demeaned me and he talked down to me. So she was, Teresa was abused where you could see her scars. My scars you couldn't see. So if you are raped or you are victimized, verbally abused or physical abuse, do not stay with the pig that did this to you. Because even if you think that, oh, daddy's going to change, they don't change.
Nope.
They're always going to be the same pigs that they were.
Mm-hmm.
You're good enough to move pigs.
That's right.
And always remember, because when a man is physically abusing the woman, okay, verbally abusing the woman, okay,
that means their self-image is shot down the drain.
Must
already.
Of themselves
already. Already.
Came from a household. Who knows? Because it's everything falls into a family cycle. And who knows? That man has a psychological problem because maybe his father was abusing his mother.
Exactly.
You see what I'm saying? So this is why I thank God when I asked God this year, please send me, you know, someone that can love me, that can understand me. He sent me Mark. Mark, again, like I said, I'm very thankful. You've been very patient with me. Yeah, sometimes I go off the handle and he's done hung up the phone on me. And I'm like, okay, don't you call me no more. You know?
But that's right. That's it, though.
But, no, but yeah. In a way, that's a way to cool me down.
Exactly.
And he knows
gives
how to
me
handle.
Time. Yeah, he knows how to handle me. You see what I'm saying? And then it gives me time. I'm like, you know, hey, you know, he's understanding. But like I said, it's a 50-50. You see what I'm saying?
Just remember, if you're single, we have a nice guy here. Don't forget.
I'm single.
Okay, sorry. Single? Okay, not single. My bad.
Nah, I ain't gonna say that.
He's saying, you're trying to put you on.
Yeah, but anyways.
Don't forget, no.
Yeah.
And no damaged goods.
Yeah. Give me contact for that, too, because I love fashion. So
right here.
Know.
Read it.
Yeah, I'll take that.
And I'm going to stand to the camera, because if you see it, it's going to say damaged
yeah.
goods.
Yeah.
Okay?
But anyways, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's your boy, El Sizzle, captain of the planes, flight boss to the Jets. You know what I'm saying? Got to close out the show, NMS Youthology Hour. You already know how we do it every single Wednesday from 7 to 8. And I would like to thank y'all for being here, because this
oh,
was excellent.
Pleasure.
And you guys
definitely.
Are welcome back anytime. So,
anytime.
You know what I'm saying?
Anytime.
You got some more stuff. And I would like to actually, you know, be active in what you guys are doing, too. So,
oh,
you know,
I would love that.
I'm kind of interested
yeah,
in that.
Yeah.
Okay,
so,
Dawn Life,
yeah.
what you got to say for us?
Dawn Life Q, Wavy of the Boss Dawn, Batman Bruce Wayne, Young Bugari. You know what it is. We're about to close out the
Dorothy,
show.
We love you.
We love
and
you.
We're praying for you for your
oh,
surgery.
Oh, yes, Dorothy.
God bless you. She just came on board with us.
Yes. Thank you.
Okay.
Word.
That's a wrap.
Yeah,
you
that's
say
a wrap.
That's a wrap?
Yeah, that's what we usually do.
Cut.
That's what we usually do.
That's
this is interesting, though.
Yeah,
big cartel.
Come on, guys. Want to take some pictures with me real quick?
Okay, cool.
I like this. I got a lot of friends. And-